going on, everybody? You guys probably know or can guess where I'm what I'm getting ready for. Don't really get ready for the gym. Don't mind that. Haley got me that. Haley got me Pikachu for, I don't know, she went to Build-A-Bear. I'm going to go hit legs. Yesterday I had fun. If you guys watched that vlog, I was driving a Lamborghini Huracan, me and Aunt. And so I ended up taking off today. Today I got legs, so I'm getting ready for that. And I'll see you guys at the gym. Probably record a couple of my workouts and then breakdown. I didn't get half my workout, I forgot. Here's a pump. Heavier. Okay. I know I showed you guys the most boring part, which is the leg extensions, but I completely forgot to vlog everything. Haley's not here, so she can't record my lifts. Nice little pump. I'm about to hit some cardio. Get home, get to the charts after the workout. Same thing as any other day. So, oh, I might hit something. I might hit like calves or something. I really didn't need to hit calves. You guys can't see him from the covering up. Ha! Treadmill. For like 15 minutes because it's leg day, so I'll get at you guys when I'm in the car. Looks like it's raining again. It's been raining for like the past week in New Jersey, guys.
Yo, what's going on, YouTube? So I'm gonna be breaking down GBBJPY and how I called out a beautiful trade, guys. It was 150 pips. I called that to my students, and it was beautiful, guys. 150 pips, price just flew. And if it wasn't the end of the week, here's another example. If it wasn't the end of the week, we would have held for much longer, for about 200 pips, as price continued to push up once market opened on Sunday. So, yes, this trade was on a Friday. And we're going to be going over why we took our positions and how we exactly got the most precise entry that we could, using a couple more tools that I'm implementing into my trade. So again, if you guys are interested in learning Forex from square one, square two, square 10, have been trading for a couple years, want to get funded, hit me up, guys. Message me, comment on my videos, Instagram me, email at alex.romero@rockmill.com. Sorry. And we'd get together, all right? So I'm going to be showing you guys how I took longs on GBP, JPY. So going into GBBJPY, I had a couple notes of one thing starting on the weekly time frame. You guys know I do top-down analysis. So when I analyze the market, I start from the higher time frames all the way down to the lower ones. Price has been pushing up so much. One, two, three, four, five, six bullish candles, weekly candles. So I'm like, listen, what comes up must go down, right? And it seems like after hitting the supply and demand area, we could potentially start to go down. Right, so you know, I kept those things in mind. We're pushing a supply and demand area. I do believe we're gonna go long short, right? So I kept that in my mind. But on the daily time frame, we've been pushing. Sorry, I just broke. On the daily time frame, we've been pushing higher highs and higher lows in a bullish trend, right? So after we got this new higher high, I wanted price to pull back to the most previous area of support and resistance, which is this pivot point right here, right? So I had a beautiful higher high to higher low. If you go down to the 12-hour, beautiful structure to the upside. If you go down to the 4-hour, still beautiful structure to the upside. We're going to take our fib, and, you know, of course, we get the most perfect 0.618 touch right there, right? So we're at our area of support and resistance, right? We're at our area of support and resistance. We're retesting previous market structure area. We also have this key supply and support and resistance area that we have drawn up. We have the 0.618. And if you look at the simple moving averages, they don't look pretty on the 4-hour, but I always tell everybody, right? You want to look at it where it makes sense. And what made the most sense was the 12-hour, where price saw it reject the 20 SMA beautifully, right? Not even that, but look at the 12-hour, the 4-hour, so many bearish candles. Just like I want the weekly to correct, right? This is going to correct too, right? So where am I going to enter, right? I'm going to enter off a couple of things, right? I want to shift the structure, and I also want a break of this counter trend line, which is what I've been using to perfect my entries, right? So currently price is pushing in a downwards trend right now, but that's only the counter trend, right? So when price starts to push and break pivot points, right, and break structure on the lower time frames, that is going to give me the shift in structure for me to finally go long. So as I called out to everybody, once price started shifting above, we're also going to wait for just an extra confirmation, and the extra confirmation was riding above the SMAs. And if you see, price went long and then it actually continued to go long, and then just blew by our and just blew by our TP, right? So here we had three TPs, right? Both of them which got hit. I'm gonna delete some things so you guys can, see them a little bit more clear, right? TP1, which is my break-even point, was hit right here at this point, and then I had the second possible price reversal area at this area over here, right? So that's why we end up taking TP 2T right over here. We also woke up and it was like New York Friday. I didn't want to hold this trade, so price eventually went up still a little bit more. But we ended up taking profit for three times our risk. This is a little off, right? It was somewhere around here. It was like 2.9. It was like 2.9 or three times our risk. And yeah, break the trend line. We broke above exponential moving averages. We even retested it right here. Here's another point in which we retested, and then we caught 150 pips to the upside. Called out to everybody. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you guys took something from this video, and I hope you guys find ways to learn off my videos and use it into your own trading. Hope you guys all had a great day. I'm back on YouTube, guys. I'm gonna be dropping a video on Friday, and I hope you guys enjoyed the Lamborghini video. I was riding Lamborghinis. It was beautiful. Dude, that shit was like sexy, guys. Like, the inside is like a rocket ship. So, quick clips of the Lamborghini. It's not long, but watch that if you haven't. Like, comment, subscribe, turn your post notifications on so you guys can see the breakdowns before the session. Until then, wait. I'm not actually done, right? I'm not done. I'm not done. Price. What is price doing right now, guys? What is price doing? I'm going to show you guys what price is doing and what we're going to have on GBP JPY. So what's happening here, guys, right? Price is giving me on the 4 hour, right? If you look at the weekly time frame, price is actually hitting the supply and demand area, like we said, and now we're getting bearish pressure, right? If you look on the daily time frame, price has created a potential higher low point, I mean lower high point right here, showing me that we failed to create equal highs. So we could possibly potentially have a bearish structure, right? On top of that, the 4 hour, this beautiful time frame confluence, the 4 hour is creating a double top and created a lower low point. Once we hit that lower low point, you guys know that I am ready to take beautiful shorts pending a pullback, but the pullback is going to have more confluences to it, right? It's going to be retesting support and resistance. It's going to be retesting the neckline of the double top. It's also going to have a pip confluence because the support and resistance are lined up with the 0.36, and the moving averages are now riding on top. So by the time we get up to the zone to retest, we're probably going to be retesting that EMA as well, and it'll look something like this, right, before we end up going to drop. And I do believe that we're eventually going to come down and hit all the way down to 161.131 before another type of trade goes through. So this chart looks crazy. It's because I just, draw as I talk. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you guys catch this move with me. I'm going to be looking to take long in this area at the 169.975 area for a beautiful short based on beautiful market structure, as you guys see here. Again, like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in London. Deuces.